This is a little update on the reefer 250 we set up here in the store. So it's going through this nasty kind of diatom bloom. So like I said early on in the channel, if you guys have been watching, I want to show you the good and I want to show you the bad. So very not pretty. Some of the corals, not the happiest. They're getting covered with this brown light film sort of dusty algae. I think it's a diatom outbreak, probably from the new rock, just having a new system. This is very, very common with new reef tanks. I wanted to quickly show it to you because it's probably as bad as it's gonna get, and then I'm gonna show you how to fix it and how to get it nice and squeaky clean again. So just a quick rundown of our little problem going on here in the reefer. All right, so here's the reefer, the Red Sea Reefer 250, about 7 days, I wanna say 7 days later. And you can see most of the diatom has cleaned up. So yeah, diatom is basically, it's just a brown, ugly algae. It's very, very common in new reef tanks. It's nothing really to worry about. It's probably the easiest algae, in my opinion, to beat. You can see there is some still left here on the bottom of this Gorgonian, and maybe a little bit kind of down here on the rock, but way, way better than what it was about a week ago. So it can affect old tanks too, but I find it's really, really common in new tanks. It's got this characteristically ugly, kind of rusty brown color, sometimes confused with dinos, but they are different. And basically they survive off silicates. So where do the silicates come from in our tank? They get added in a number of ways. So one is unfiltered tap water. So if you're using tap water, that's a very common way to get silicates in the water. It's still kind of persistent down here on these bottom of the hammers. It's not completely gone, it's almost gone. But yes, that's why we recommend, reasons like that, why we always recommend using RO or even better RODI water, because you're just getting the cleanest source water for your reef tank. It can also come from new rock. So this is all brand new, too little fishy stack rock. So that can leach out some silicates and phosphates into the water. And you can even get it from salt. So the way that the salt brands are manufactured, just part of the manufacturing method, silicates are used. I think it's a preservative, I could be wrong. But yeah, silicates are in the salt. So that's why it's very, very common in new tanks, because you got all this new water and all this new salt and all this new rock, even the sand can produce some of the silicates. So all of that really feeds the dino and it just takes off. And it's almost every reef tank I've ever started. I think every single one that I can remember. Yeah, you get a dino bloom in the beginning. And then usually you clear that up and you're off to the races and you're good. Sorry, I said dino. Matt's here, he's correcting me. They're very common and they sound similar. Diatom. If I ever said dino in the video, go back and correct it. So sorry, diatom. So how did we get rid of it in this tank? How did we clean it up? Diatoms, like I said, they need the silicates. So we want to remove the silicates from the water. And the way I like to do that is with this product over here. Just walk over and grab it real quick. It's called Rolofoss. This is a very old product, very, very well known. It's been on the market forever. It's a granular ferric oxide, GFO, and it sucks up phosphates, and it also sucks up, what do you know? Also sucks up, where am I? Silicates. Very, very good silicate absorber, phosphate absorber. So this, if you run this in the tank, it'll essentially starve out the diatom, and it won't be able to grow. So that's one thing we did with the tank to help. And then the second thing we did was snails. So Astrea snails, these we keep them all over the store. They're really small. These guys are awesome at cleaning up diatom. These ones here, the only thing to keep in mind with them, they're pretty inexpensive. They're really effective algae eaters, but they won't flip themselves. So if they're like this in your tank, if they end up on their back, you actually have to go and flip them over. It's kind of a pain. You can see we have them everywhere. I keep them in every single tank. They're kind of the backbone of any good cleanup crew. So I think we added about 20, 25 of them. And they just plow through the stuff. I should have shot a video the day after we added them because it's really cool. You can see sort of the lanes of the snails as they just devour the algae. So yeah, between those two, basically gone within a week. And if you do nothing, actually, the algae will go away on its own. It's one of those algaes, it'll starve itself out because it'll consume all the silicates. And I've seen some people online say water change. I've found in my experience, at least, the water change actually makes it worse because you continue to provide it with a new source of silicates from salt, and maybe you're not using, you know, the cleanest water, And if it's coming in through your tap water, you actually end up making the problem a lot worse. So this is a weird algae where, in my experience, water change can make it worse and actually won't help it. I wouldn't reduce to lights. I've seen some people say lights out or tank blackout. I think that's way too drastic. It's not necessary. Unless maybe it's a new tank, I would say look at how much white light you're running. Like if you're running a light that you can control the LEDs, maybe you're running too much white light. So that could be a problem there. But yeah, it's probably the easiest algae to beat. I'll do another maybe like quick update in a future video in a week just to show you how clean it is. So this rock is going to go kind of back to, it's not going to go back to the white like how it originally was. It's going to go yellowy and then it's going to start to go green, and then you're going to start to see all the nice purple and pink and red coralline that we're looking for pop up on the rock. But yeah, that's it for the diatoms today. I don't know why I keep wanting to say dino. That's it for today's video. Like I said, I want to document the good and the bad. I think it's too easy to just show you happy fish and corals and thriving reef tanks. You know, stuff does go wrong even for us. So I'm going to continue to show you when stuff like that does happen and how we fix it. And hopefully if I can share or pass on some of the knowledge or my experiences and help someone out there, that's great. But yeah, I think that's it for today's video. If you guys got any questions, you know you can always hit us up. Phone number, feel free to call us. Email, we are located here in Toronto, and I am in love with this hammer. You can't see in the camera how nice this is. It's actually blue. This is a blue hammer with gold stripes. And I'm a little colorblind, but it's actually blue. It's really nice. Okay, happy reefy. Thanks for watching, guys.